Week four. This discussion post is about if we've ever been in a crisis and how we would deal with it, and if we haven't, how we deal with it. Right off the bat, you should start out by knowing I have never personally been involved in a crisis. I've never been tested like that. I've never had to really know how I would deal with certain things in certain situations like that. But on the other hand, I've had kind of a very, very interesting childhood. You know, anyone that knows me knows that when I was very, very young, I have a little bit of history with abuse. That's not necessarily in my memory or anything like that, but it is something that impacted the development of my life. And then at a couple of points in my teenage years, to where twice I was thrown into a community that was in the middle of grieving over a tragedy that had just happened to them that I have absolutely no personal attachment to whatsoever. You know, most of us in our age group know that in 1999, Columbine High School. So I moved from Fresno to Littleton, Colorado in 2000. And so that was absolutely insane to just move right into a community of people that had just gone through one of the worst national, if not global, tragedies, especially for the genre of what happened. To just move in the middle of seventh grade into a community of where all that happened to pretty much anyone you come in contact to, they have some sort of personal attachment to it, and you don't. And so to try to make some friends and to try to go through social situations and maybe learn, you know, as a 13-year-old child, try to learn about how the world works. Just the you are one connection away from someone that is just absolutely deeply involved in that. Into 2003, we move into a suburb community north of New York City. And so it's kind of crazy that 9/11 had happened a couple of years prior, less than a couple of years prior. And then we get involved in a community that's involved with a rebuild. Ground Zero was still very much Ground Zero. It was just kind of a crazy time, the prime of my teenage years. And I get thrown into a community of people where you are one connection away from people who are absolutely devastating, and you have absolutely no personal attachment to anything that's going on. And so I wasn't thrown on the outside by any means. Like, no one made me go on the outside, but by nature, just on the outside looking in. And I didn't realize how much that was gearing me to be the adult that I am. But at the time, I didn't know what was happening. I thought that I thought the world was a pretty screwed up place. They keep moving to all these places that are, Denver is a worldwide known awesome place to be. New York City is one of the most thriving cities on the entire planet. We as adults love to use the term of that, you know, everyone's going through their own internal crisis. Everyone's going through something. Everyone's got some sort of stress that they're dealing with that they're not sharing with every single person that they run into. It's just weird how something like that can bring a lot of people closer together. And it's unfortunately that it takes something like that to bring people closer together. But it does show the spirit of people and the condition of people that we want to help support each other. And I think as counselors, it's important to remember that. And if you ever go through a crisis or have to go through a crisis, it's important to remember that the people around you are going through it too. And so don't isolate yourself. Don't make it feel like you're alone, because there's other people that feel the same thing you do. And it doesn't take someone that's gone through it to understand. I've been around people that have gone through tragedies enough to understand that it's a very fragile and sensitive situation. And so it's prepared me as an adult to help deal with those things. And so that's my response for this week. Take care.